Hi, it's David here from Freedom Founders. You know, a lot of people are in a real quandary today, really trying to figure out what their next move is. You see, we're in a time period in the history of our country, really globally as well, but a time period in our country that most people have not seen, experienced, or endured because we haven't seen what we're seeing right now historically over at least the last 40 years. If you go back to the 1970s and the early 80s, where we had what was called stagflation, that's inflation with a very anemic economy, high inflation, high interest rates, and an economy that was barely getting by, you'll understand that we were possibly entering that same era. What people don't realize is that how important it is to understand the effects, the forces of inflation, which are in great extent caused by the debt that the country, you know, the U.S. is the greatest debtor nation in the world today on the globe by a massive amount. The unprecedented amount of stimulus money, fiat currency, digital printing, if you will, expansion of credit that has occurred just in the last 16 months has been logarithmic, geometrically expanded way beyond what we've ever seen before, way beyond what happened in 2008, the downturn recession. All of this money now is overtaking the deflationary effects that we've had because of globalism and technology, which typically deflate or cause the economy not to overinflate. We're way past that point. And of course, the Federal Reserve says, don't worry, don't worry. It's just transitory. Well, of course, they said, don't worry, don't worry. Back when the subprime financial mortgage crisis was melting down, it was all good. They have it all contained. You can't trust the Fed. They're going to tell you what they want to tell you because they obviously want to try to detract from the emotional response that the markets will have, the people will have. Well, we're seeing a response right now. We're seeing the ugly tail of inflation starting to rise up. April, 4.2% CPI increase. May, 5%. It's going to go higher. Now, here's what most people don't understand, is that inflation has the same effect as compound interest, the thing that we love, because when we invest money or invest in assets or other investments, and we get the compound effect, that compound effect of the interest increases that asset value over time. Well, inflation does the exact reverse. See, if you've been of the conventional thinking, which most people are because it's conventional, it's conservative to think about saving your money, getting out of debt, which is what we were taught, our parents, our grandparents, what Dave Ramsey certainly espouses. We go that route, you're likely to be hit on the wrong side by the tidal wave of the debt and the inflation tsunami. You don't want to be there. Again, this goes completely contrary to what we believe, what we're taught to believe. But if you don't follow, if you follow the majority and don't find a non-traditional path, you're likely to be hit like the majority of people will, because they'll keep doing the same thing they've been doing, keeping their fingers crossed or working with advisors or people who don't understand how do you mitigate these massive forces that are upon us today. It's critical you have to understand that the massive debt of this country is going to force our nation and other nations as well, but it's particularly our nation, to what we call monetize the debt. That is, inflation is the way that one can erode debt. Think about it this way. If you are borrowing money, you or me, at say 3 or 4% on a business or real estate or any other type of investment, we're borrowing because we know how to use good sound leverage. So if it's 3 or 4% and if the inflation rate is running at the same 3 or 4%, then realize that the cost of our borrowing, whatever the interest rate we're paying, is negated by the inflation rate. It's negated, so the cost of our borrowing is actually zero. What would you buy or acquire or invest in if your cost to borrow was zero interest? Well, probably you'd make some good moves. What if the inflation rate is higher than our cost of borrowing? So if our cost to borrow is 3 to 4%, inflation is running at 5, 6. Well, remember back in the 70s and 80s, it was running in double digits, up to 14.5%. So now our cost of borrowing, if you will, or the debt that we've been carrying at 3 or 4%, if the inflation rate is say 10%, then we are at -6 or 7%. Well, that would really entice someone to borrow. Well, that's the point. But here's the key. You can't just borrow money to borrow money. You can't, this is not consumption lifestyle I'm talking about, not building a bigger house or buying more cars because, oh gee, the cost of my carrying the interest is zero or negative. No, you have got to be using the debt in a wise way. This is the key. What assets can you invest in? Can you use the debt at fixed rates over a long period of time so that inflation will erode that debt, just as I just taught you? Well, it's got to be revenue producing, cash flow producing assets. One very well could be a business or businesses. Many of you are in business, and that's a good thing, but have you really created a business that is not just another job? I'm talking about assets where you don't have to be there creating, producing the income. Real assets, I love real estate, because real estate, I can acquire the asset, set it one time, and then the revenue, when well managed, that's another key. How do you find the good management? But if it's well managed and you use proper leverage, then you're basically, with higher inflation, are going to be getting the loan or paying the debt off with zero cost to you, or very likely negative. See, that's how you short the dollar. That's how you make use and get on the right side of the debt and inflation, what I call the tsunami that's coming. If you play the game on a conservative basis, you and most people are going to get absolutely pummeled by the waves. And someday down the road, not too far down the road, you're going to wonder what the heck happened. You did everything right by the book, the way people told you to do it. And yet you end up towards the end of your life after you want to get out of active income production and wonder, where is it? See, that's why the traditional financial models don't work. The accumulation model. People tell you, financial advisors say, well, you need to pile up, you know, investments in all kinds of different products. And typically high income earners need $6, $8, $10 million. Well, fine and good if you can get there with higher taxes. Good luck getting there. But let's say you can get there. Now they play the depletion model. Well, you can take out 3, maybe 4% of that nest egg and will hopefully last you 25 years. Well, that's a hope and a prayer, not the plan that I want. But now let's add in the inflation effect. See, inflation is going to take that accumulation model, that nest egg, and deplete it so quickly that probably your ability to take any principal out on the way is going to be negated completely. In other words, is that nest egg producing any income at all? See, most of the time it doesn't, or it's very, very low. So you've got to be able to learn how to invest in assets that produce income that's hedged to inflation, both on the value standpoint and on the revenue streams that it's produced. That's where alternative investments, real estate, beats financial investments, Wall Street, hands down. And we're in an era right now that if you don't understand that, you don't know how to access the opportunities, understand where to put your money, who are the people that can help you do it? Not Wall Street, but who are the real people? If you don't have that in your back pocket, good luck. This is not a time to be doing it yourself. In Freedom Founders, we have created a community, a model that is co-created to get you to your freedom point faster than you ever thought. And here's the killer thing. Most of our members, by far the majority, are much closer than they thought to real financial freedom. They just didn't have the model. They didn't know how to do it. If you want to learn how to utilize the forces and not be drowned by the tsunami, you've got to take some next steps forward. I encourage you to take next steps. We've got an easy way to do it to see if you're qualified to be a part of our community. We'll help you if there's a fit. If you're not, definitely show you the best place for you to go to get the help, to get you ready to take advantage of the forces that are coming. Again, I say, focus on your freedom and may the force be with you.